and said to Peter and to the other disciples, "Brothers, what should we do?" Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, so that your sins may be forgiven, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is for you, for your children, and for all who are far away, everyone whom the Lord our God calls to him." And he testified with many other arguments and exhorted them, saying, "Save yourselves from this corrupt generation." For those who welcomed his message were baptized, and that day about 3,000 people were added. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And one of them, whose name was Cleopas, answered him, Are you the only stranger in Jerusalem who doesn't know the things that have taken place these days? And Jesus asked them, what things? They replied, the things about Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how our chief priests and leaders handed him over to be condemned to death and crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one to redeem Israel. Yes, and besides all this, it's now the third day since these things took place. And moreover, some women in our group astounded us. They went to the tomb early this morning, and when they did not find his body there, they came back and told us that they had seen a vision of angels who said he was alive. Some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it, just as the women said, but they didn't see him. Then Jesus said to them, oh, how foolish you are and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have declared. Wasn't it necessary for the Messiah to suffer these things and enter into his glory? And then beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them the things about himself in all the scriptures. And as they came near to the village to which they were going, Jesus walked ahead as if he was going on. But they urged him strongly, saying, stay with us, because it's almost evening, and the day is now nearly over. So he went and stayed with them. And when he was at table with them, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to them. Their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, and Jesus vanished from their sight. They said to each other, were our hearts not burning within us while he was talking to us on the road, while he was opening scripture to us? That same hour they got up and returned to Jerusalem, and they found the 11 and their companions together, and they were saying, the Lord has risen indeed and has appeared to Simon. And then they told what had happened to them on the road, and how Jesus had been made known to them in the breaking of the bread. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.